In an historic first, a kidney from a genetically modified pig has been successfully transplanted into a human. As William Brangham reports, the technique used in the surgery last weekend is a big step forward and could have wide implications.
The patient here is a 62-year-old black man whose kidneys were failing and he was on dialysis for years. This kind of human-to-animal transplant, known as xenotransplantation, is one that researchers hope to do more of because there aren't nearly enough human organs for the thousands of people in need. But putting animal tissue into a human body is complicated. The body often rejects foreign tissue. So in this case, scientists removed several genes from the pig that can trigger that rejection. To help us understand this brave new world, we are joined by Dr. Leonardo Riella. He's the medical director for kidney transplantation at Massachusetts General Hospital, where this historic event took place. Dr. Riella, so good to have you on the program. Congratulations on this historic, successful first. I take it is still successful, right? The patient is doing well?
The patient is doing extremely well. Thank you for asking.
And what is his, his prognosis? Normally, if you had a kidney transplant, how soon would he be getting out of the hospital? And do you know when he will be getting out?
Yeah, so most patients remain in the hospital after a kidney transplant for about 5 to 6 days. On his case, we're probably going to keep about a week or 9 days just to make sure everything is okay. But all the signs that we had so far, in particular the blood tests and things that we follow, are extremely positive. So, and he has been off dialysis since he got his transplant last Saturday.
It's amazing. Before we get into some of the complexities here, we were all very struck by seeing how moved you were at the press conference when you announced this breakthrough. And I just wonder, if I had talked to you back when you were a younger man in medical school and I had told you that you could have cured someone's end-stage renal disease with a pig kidney, what would younger you have thought about that?
That was just a dream, a big dream, and maybe it would never happen.
And what is it, again, for people who might have thought, well, I've heard that we can put parts of pig hearts into people or other animal transplantations. What is it that has been the challenge thus far that you were able to surmount here?
So, you know, if we go back 20, 30 years when xenotransplant started, there had been so many challenges, in particular what was mentioned before about these incompatibilities. And changing the DNA to make animals more compatible was extremely difficult. I think what really changed was a game changer was the development of the CRISPR-Cas technology. And so the discovery and then the application of that in xenotransplantation, because then scientists were able to modify multiple genes at the same time in a short period of time, which, you know, before was impossible. And that permitted us to overcome all these barriers and make organs that were really more compatible with humans.
And is that why you think that this case was successful when other previous attempts have not been?
Well, that's one point that is very important, is the type of donor organ that we're going to get. What type of gene-modified pigs are donating these kidneys so that we can do a successful transplant? I think the second aspect is, what are the medications that we're going to be giving this patient in order to prevent it from rejecting? What we've learned from all preclinical models, so animal studies, is that the usual immune suppressive drugs, anti-rejection medications that we use in the clinic, do not seem to be effective in the case of xenotransplantation. And what we had to do is then adapt some of the new drugs that were being developed. And for the first time, we used one of these medications on the current patient. And I think that was so far a success. Of course, rejection takes time, so we have to follow this patient carefully. But the initial impression is only positive from our team.
Can you help me understand a little bit the potential that you and your colleagues see for this type of thing, given the enormous need, tens of thousands of people, and we know the big disparities in racial minorities in the country?
Yeah, those are huge. The disparity in kidney transplantation keeps increasing, and as well as the organ shortage. So patients don't get referred for transplant, and when they do get referred, they have to wait on a waiting list years before getting a transplant. And unfortunately, while they stay on dialysis, their health deteriorate. So while they were initial candidates for a kidney transplant when they first entered the list, if they wait 4 to 5 years, many of them will not be candidates anymore. So I think what we hope to be able to do is that one first step in getting more organs for these patients so they can be transplanted in a timely manner.
There have been a series of concerns that have been raised about using gene-edited organs in humans, about the potential for spreading animal viruses from animals to humans. How do you weigh those risks versus the potential that you're talking about here?
That's always a major debate in the entire field of xenotransplantation. So how high are the risks? And what we have learned over the past 20 years with many animal studies is that if these pigs are grown in a very isolated manner with frequent testing, you're able to actually, you know, have a very low risk of infections. And I think what was unique about the pig that donated the kidney for our patient was that in addition to the improvements in compatibility that we just mentioned, they also did 59 modifications in the gene, in particular in some retroviruses that are present endogenously on the pig. And so that creates an extra level of safety in terms of minimizing infections coming from the pig. And then we tested for all the other pathogens, bacteria and viruses that could be present on the pig to make sure that they were negative prior to transplantation, and that reassures. So the risk overall we consider very low, but of course, this is the first time we're doing this in humans, so we're going to be monitoring this very carefully.
All right, Dr. Leonardo Riella of Massachusetts General Hospital, thank you so much, and again, congratulations on this historic breakthrough.
Thank you so much. Appreciate it.